Welcome, myself Giridhar Jain, Assistant Professor in Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now today, I am going to explain you the programming of interfacing circuits with microcontroller 89C51. Now learning outcomes of this session are, at the end of this session, students will be able to write assembly language program for interfacing circuits for 89C51 with switches, LEDs, matrix keyboard, relay and buzzer. Contents of the session are interfacing of switches and LED, interfacing of switches and relays, interfacing of switches, relays and buzzer. Now this is the interfacing circuit which we have discussed in the last video. So this is matrix keyboard. So for matrix keyboard, these are the four lines. These are three and four lines used as shown in figure. These are the LEDs. This is interfacing of buzzer. And these are the relays. So here this is P1.0, P1.1, P1.2, this is 3, P1.4, 5, 6 and 7. So these are the 3 keys arranged in the first row, 3 in second, 3 in third and 3 key arranged in the 4. So interfacing of switches and LED. Now write a program if switch S1 is pressed, make LED 1 on, and if switch S2 is pressed, make LED 1 off. So think on solution of this programming task. So here if switch S1 is pressed, LED 1 should be made on, and if switch S2 is pressed, LED 1 should be made off. So this operation is equivalent to a flip-flop. Now this is flowchart for this programming task. For every programming task, first you should prepare a flowchart, and according to the flowchart, the program is to be written. So first decision box, check if S1 is pressed. If S1 is pressed, if it is yes, LED 1 is on. If S1 is not pressed, no, then go to check S2 is pressed. If S2 is pressed, if yes, LED 1 should be made off. Or if S2 is not pressed, then continue in a loop. Means you have to check S1 and S2 continuously. And if S1 is pressed, you will make LED 1 on, and if S2 is pressed, you have to make that same LED off. Now let us discuss the programming. So first statement for the assembly language program is .org00h. So this is start address after the reset. So when microcontroller is reset, the program counter of the microcontroller is pointed toward this address 0000h. Therefore, first instruction is to be written at this address. Then S jump, short jump to a ST, .org0040h. Immediately after this, at the address 0000h, this location and next two location, we can write the S jump instruction. And the next memory locations are reserved for the interrupt vector address. Therefore, we have to jump to an address other than that. So here .org0040h means the next program is starting from this address 40h. So ST, this is a label. So clear P1.4. So why this is done? So clear P1.4 means the row 1 is active. Make row 1 active, then loop to check if S1 is pressed, jump a bit P1.0 to DN1, check if S1 is pressed. If S1 is pressed, then clear P2.0 means LED 1 will become on. If S1 is not pressed, this is true and it will jump to the DN1. So in this level DN1, jump if bit P1.1 to DN2, check if S2 is pressed. If S2 is not pressed, jump to a loop, and if S2 is pressed, set B P2.0 means P2.0 bit is set to 1, means that LED 1 will become off. So LED is made on by outputting 0 at P1.0, and LED is made off by outputting 1 to that port line. So this is a complete program for the programming task given. Means if S1 is pressed, LED 1 is on here, and if S2 is pressed, LED 1 is off. And S jump loop means it will jump in a loop for continuously checking switch S1 and S2. Now next, interfacing of switches and relays. Now write a program: if switch S1 is pressed, make relay 1 on. If S2 is pressed, make relay 2 on. And if S3 is pressed, make both the relays off. So .org00h, sjumpst, .org0040, as we have done in the previous program. So first we have to check whether S1 is pressed. So clear P1.0 means make row 1 active, because switch S1 is in the first switch in the row 1. Loop, jump if bit P1.0 to DN1, check if S1 is pressed. If S1 is pressed, clear P2.5. So relay interfacing circuit is connected at P2.5, therefore that bit is clear. Then check if S2 is pressed. So jump if bit P1.1 to DN2. If switch S2 is pressed, make relay 2 on. So relay 2 is interface at port line P2.4. Therefore, that port line is clear by the instruction clear P2.4. Next. Now we have to check whether S3 is pressed. And if S3 is pressed, we have to make both the relays off. So here DN2, jump if bit P1.2. DN3, check if S3 is pressed. If S3 is pressed, we have to make both the relays off, means P2.4 and P2.5 should be set. So set B P2.5, relay 1 will become off, and set B P2.4, relay 2 will be off. DN3, jump in a loop. So jump to a loop for continuously checking if status of switch S1, S2 and S3. Now next is interfacing of switches, relays and buzzer. So this is a programming statement. Write a program: if switch S1 is pressed, make relay 1 on. If S2 is pressed, make relay 2 on. If S3 is pressed, make both the relays off. If S4 is pressed, make the buzzer on, and if S6 is pressed, buzzer is made off. So this is extension of earlier programming task. So in earlier programming task, we have used switch S1 and S2. If S1 is pressed, relay 1 is on. S2 is pressed, relay 2 is on. And if S3 is switch on, or if S3 is on, relay 1 and 2 are off. So this is a programming task of earlier program, and extension is the interfacing of buzzer. Means if S4 is pressed, buzzer should be on, and if S6 is pressed, buzzer is off. So this program is earlier program as it is, only we have changed. So instead of jumping here in a loop, so we are continuing the program. So .org00h, sjumpst, .org0040, So row 1 active, clear P1.4. Jump if bit P1.0 to DN1, check if S1 is press relay 1 on. Then check if S2 is press, jump if bit P1.1 relay 2 on. And check if switch S3 is press, jump if bit P1.2. So relay 1 is off and the relay 2 is off. So here previously we are continuing in a loop. So DN3 set B P1.4 means after this, means after checking S1, S2 and S3, and by taking the appropriate action, we have to activate the next row, because switch S4 and S6 are positioned in the second row. So set BP1.4 means row 1 is off, clear P1.5 means row 2 is active, jump if bit P1.0 means check if S4 is press. If S4 is press, clear P2.6 means buzzer is on. Now check if switch S6 is press, so jump if bit P2.1.2 to DN5. If S6 is press, buzzer is off by setting the bit P2.6 by set B P2.6. Then DN5, set B P1.5, row 2 is made off, clear P1.4, row 1 is made on, and S jump in a loop for continuously checking the status of S1, S2, S3, S4 and S6 and taking the appropriate action. So these are the references. Thank you for watching this video.